In this video, we are going to solve some uniform motion problems. And I already went over in the first video how we got the pictures, and so now we're going to continue to completely solve some problems. So remember the formula though, rate times time equals distance. This was the first problem we looked at. Two cyclists start at the same corner and ride in opposite directions. One cyclist rides twice as fast as the other. In 3 hours, they are 81 miles apart. Find the rate of each cyclist. So we decided this was the picture. They started from the same spot, went in opposite directions, and eventually they end up 81 miles apart from each other. Okay, so now we need to set up some variables, and I like to use a chart to do this. So I'm going to have cyclist 1 and cyclist 2. One's going to be faster than the other, and we're going to put something in for their rate and something in for their time. And then their distance we're going to get by multiplying rate times time. All right, so what do we know? One cyclist rides twice as fast. So the speed's twice as fast. The rate's twice as fast. So let's say the first cyclist is going x miles per hour, then the other cyclist would be going 2x miles per hour. All right. What do we know about their time? Well, you're assuming they're leaving at the same time because it doesn't say anything else, and that they're going for 3 hours. So each of them travels for 3 hours. That's their time. So rate times time equals distance. This is 3x, and this is 3 times 2x, which is 6x. So now I could go up and put this on the picture. Move this a little bit down. Okay, so cyclist 1, now the whole idea of this picture is I want to put in the distance that I get for each. So this is 3x, that distance right here, and the distance for cyclist 2 is 6x. Now we look at the picture. This piece plus this piece has to equal the total of 81, and that is your equation. 3x plus 6x is 81. We go down here. 3x plus 6x equals 81. 9x is 81. Divide both sides by 9. So x is 9. All right, now what does x stand for? X stands for the rate of cyclist 1. So we're going to now actually fill in the real numbers into the chart for cyclist 1. It has a rate and a time and a distance. So we've got, for cyclist 1, we've got 9. So cyclist 2 at 2x would be 18. They each went 3 hours. So their distance, rate times time equals distance, is for the first, the cyclist 1 would be 27, and cyclist 2 would be 54. This is sort of like your check, okay? All right, so now let's see, would it be true on that picture that cyclist 1 went 27 miles and cyclist 2 went 54? Let's see. 27, 54. Would they end up being 81 miles apart from each other? Sure, because 27 plus 54 is 81. All right, now let's see what the question is. Find the rate of each cyclist. Okay, so the rates are 9 miles per hour and 18 miles per hour. What's nice about this little chart in the end, if it would have asked you something different, like how far did the cyclist, the slower cyclist go? And we could see 27 miles. How far did the second cyclist go? 54 miles. What if it just asked for the rate of the faster cyclist? It would be 18 miles an hour. The rate of the slower cyclist would be 9 miles an hour. All your information is right here in this chart all the info you need to check and to answer any questions you might be asked.